Thank you, madam. It's my pleasure to be here with you today to address the esteemed organizing committee, Professor Hemlata, Talesra, madam, Dr. Seema Tiagi, madam, esteemed speakers and of the webinar, esteemed coordinators of sessions, their attendants. First, I greet you all wherever you are. Good morning to those who have morning in their country. Good afternoon to those who have afternoon in their countries. Good evening to those who have evening time in their country. I say that because the participants are from 18 countries all over the world and more. So in countries, there is now morning time. Other countries, afternoon. Others, evenings. I like to congratulate the organizing committee for their invitation to this group of scholars in the field of education and leadership to participate with their fruitful ideas, which will enrich different fields of knowledge. It is not an easy job to invite distinguished experts from this number of countries all over the world in one webinar. East, West, South, and North, in addition to different places in India, either to participate with papers or to participate by attending and exchanging ideas with speakers. Also, a special greeting to my teacher, Professor Hemlata Talesra, who always support us with new fruitful ideas in education and valuable ideas in our lives. So may God bless you, Professor Hemlata, madam, and give you a long life and the best of health to continue giving us more advices and directions in education. Really, this is a good opportunity to meet my good friends who are participating in this webinar. Dr. Seema Tiagi, Professor P.K. Dashura, Professor Oshushi Guha, Dr. Bobby Mahanta, Dr. Kashori Dash, Professor Nasreen, and also to meet a new esteemed scholar from MS University of Baroda, Professor Karnam. This is also gratitude to respect to the respected university, MS University, Maharaja Sejarao University of Baroda, and to all people who work in it. There is a saying says that the one who doesn't thank people for good deeds, he doesn't thank God. So thanking people is from thanking of God. This is only part of the introduction to my paper. It is gratitude is part of the human values which I will talk now. It is about spirituality and human values in our life. Now we come to definition of spirituality. Okay. Now, spirituality is okay. Okay. Spirituality is complex and abstract and can have different meanings to different people. It is therefore difficult to capture in a single definition. Dulce sent defines the word spirit by its Latin root spiritus, which means I breathe. He says that the life essence within humans is consciousness, and that consciousness is the source of substance of all life. Spirituality can also be framed as a consciousness journey about discovering the true self. What his statement says is that each human being contains a supreme presence, but this is clouded by illusion and ignorance. In between the supreme presence and the individual is an ego and individualized consciousness, which believes it is the self. What is postulated is that self-realization and union with universe already exists. Then what is needed is to reveal the ignorance, and what remains is our true self. Therefore, the purpose of the individual is to achieve this self-realization of union with the universe. This existing union with the universe is a relationship often personified in Western countries by the name of God. Then Maulana Wahiduddin Khan defines spirituality as giving to God. So the spirituality inclines to evaluate themselves in their thinking, that they begin to live in the higher divine plane. They remain undisturbed in the face of provocation. Their mental balance is not upset by unpleasant experiences, and the distasteful behavior of others does not arouse by feeling of anger of revenge from them. Living strictly by their principles, their mental level becomes so high with the stone and cast by the others cannot reach them. In spirituality, they find such sublimity that all else fails in significance. Spirituality in itself is such a great virtue that seeker after divine bliss need request no further. The one who finds God, what did he lose? Nothing. And the one who lost God, what did he find? Nothing. This means that as long as we are with God, following the instructions, following the good deeds, following the ideas which we received from God, we are so strong. We do not do bad things or wrong things. We do not do sins or mistakes, because we feel always God is in ourselves. And if we do not lose this power, that is to be not in good relation with God, means that we have nothing to work for, to do for in our life. Because of that, we say the one who finds God, he is always be with God. He did not lose anything. His life will be, he is living, everyone is living a quiet life, peaceful life, and happy life. life, spiritual, here, defines, Mr. Delbecq defines spirituality as a unique of personal inner experience and search for a fullest personal development through participation of non-present money, mystery. It always involves a sense of belonging to for more complete fulfillment through touching the greater mystery, which is some in the Western countries, the God. So here also, in the non-religious concept. Even spirituality is putting emphasis on a well-being of mind, body, spirit. This usually includes holistic activities such as yoga and meditation. Spirituality exists in all traditions and cultures. You can put your spirituality into practice in your daily life through ordinary everyday activity. Sometimes you see somebody for the first time and you feel that you have a good relation with that person, although that is the first time you meet him. I give you an example here. On 10th of September this year, Tamil Nadu Teachers Education University in Chennai, in cooperation with the Guri College of Education, they held a webinar under the title of education, something like that. So there I met new friends, new speakers, new colleagues for the first time. And really I felt, from the first time I felt that I know them earlier. That the same as they have good relation with them, although it's the first time, but I felt that there is a spiritual change, spiritual respect with them. So this proves that whether you are a religious believer or non-religious believer, there is spirituality between them. There's a relation between our spirits. So those people whom I introduced for the first time, I saw them for the first time, they are still in my mind, and they will remain for a long time, not only for 1 or 2 days or 1 year or year, because I feel that they are more than relatives. Spirits introduce each other, and these spirits one day will do to make our bodies meet. So spirituality includes our spiritual practices or spiritual disciplines, which may include prayer, meditation, breathing exercise, and ceremonies or rituals. Spirituality and our spiritual life also includes us daily interaction with other people. Studying of spiritual science is integral to help us understanding the importance of why we should do spiritual practice. Only when the intellect is convinced about the importance of practicing spirituality can we make concerned efforts to do spiritual practice regularly. Understanding spiritual principles give us the ability to make better decisions about our life and also about our spiritual practice. Prayer is one of the main ways to practice our spirituality. It is an effort to communicate with Allah, the Creator, the higher power, the God, the Guru, or to an object of worship. Prayer also very powerful. Our prayers are one of our natural healing resources each one of us can use today and any time in the day. The medicine of prayer is a good way to maintain good health. Prayers usually offer praise, thanks, make a request, or simply express one's thoughts and emotions to help us be harmony, balance, and peace. It can be done anyway or in many ways. Before we do the prayers, also we purify ourselves. We clean ourselves, we clean our clothes, clean the place where we sit. And then after that, we start praying. Praying is not only a movement, it is not only exercises. Yes, there are exercises and movements, but more than that, spiritual purity. Our spirits will be pure before we start praying. Then at the time when we clarify ourselves, we start praying. Prayers can be said out loud, quietly, through song, dance, and tears. You can also pray in any position, standing, lying down, sitting, and kneeling, with hands flooded, raised, opened, and closed, and so on. When a person is truly in his spiritual self, in prayer, he does not focus on his body, mind, and emotion. In a total spiritual state, people do not feel pain, heat, cold, hunger, or thirst. They are praying. They forget themselves. They have nothing else other than the acceptance of the of God. That they are wishing to accept. Acceptance of God. So by praying, we express our helpless and into the worship of a task to God. Praying benefits us to a level of action, thought, and attitude. It is a cornerstone in spiritual practice because it enhances the potency of chanting the name of God. Over time, frequent prayers help to dissolve our mind and intellect, and through them we gain access to a higher universal mind and intellect. It is also an effect means of awakening our spiritual emotion. So from the spiritual the benefits of prayer, I may mention the following. Prayer improves spiritual practice. Praying impacts our spiritual practice at three levels: action, thought, and attitude. In action, all actions are preceded by prayer for spiritual benefit are performed with spiritual emotion. Hence, errors are committed. Thought, so long as the mind is active, thoughts will continue. Attitude. A prayer done with spiritual emotion, attitudes of complementation within a seeker. Receiving forgiveness for mistakes. Having committed a mistake, if one makes a prayer and surrenders unto God, then God forgives one for the mistakes. Then, reducing the ego. While praying, we plead before God. It is therefore the place where pride is abandoned, and we humbly admit the need of our human frailty as well as our dependence upon God. It helps to reduce the ego faster. Then prayer is a protection from ghosts. Praying is a powerful tool that helps protection when ghosts protected from ghosts, demons, devils, negative spirits, etc. It increases in faith. When a prayer gets answered, faith in God increases faith and is the only currency to our spiritual journey. So, benefits of prayer are many. And now, when somebody sends a message to his or her friend, life in his message said, life is not qualified by fluent English, branded clothes, or rich lifestyle. It is measured by the number of faces who smile when they hear your name. Now, why do some people smile when they hear other person's names? Try it. And if you look at yourself and remember those any one of the interested names according to you. Some people, whenever you hear their names, you smile. What makes you smile? Is it a prayer? Is it a spirit? Is it a spirit mate? Is it a spirit effect? There's something in our spirits makes us believe that spirituality is important in our life and we cannot live without it. This is just only an example. Another example, when somebody sends a message to someone else and says, a prayer can go where I cannot go. Through prayers, I can be with you without being there. I may be miles away, but my prayers will always be with you. How can be somebody be with other person, although he's far away, and says only by prayer? My prayer will always be with you, because the God is one, the God is the same, the supreme God is the what you call Allah, God, Guru, Lord. It is there. This is the power, the supreme power that guides us. It's everywhere. So when somebody say, I wish you the best, I wish you best of luck, I wish you a best of health, how does he wish? He was send the wish to the supreme God, that they send this wish to on behalf of this person, or this he, whether he or she. So benefits of prayer are many. And so we cannot count them in one, just in counting them and say this is the number one, this is number two, because they are many. And when you pray, sometimes we pray before taking food, we pray before we travel, before when we reach, before we sleep, just as a protection from the cause of other spirits which surround us. But now, also, when we talk about human ideas, we say that sometimes we are helpless, alone, if we are far from our supreme God or supreme power. Mohan stated that the human society may not significantly without the human values, that the human values are there, which control our life, make our life peaceful. Hence, it is necessary to talk on the subject and bring about awareness of human values into a modern society. There is no denying the fact that the presence of a global society is facing a lot of crisis. Human values crisis is a known fact of the modern society. Indeed, humans are aware of the global and national problems which they are currently facing, the impact of human activities on the earth in various ways and placing a significant amount of stress. It is believed that at the end of the day, it is the human values which will save mankind. If any ethics are preliminary to help person to live just a righteous life with him or his and the relation with others, ethics too is similarly oriented towards the righteous life. Personally and social life in every of every individual is permitted by the great sense of righteousness. Ethics deal with the principles of good and evil, and shows how people should treat one another. It should light on the aim they should seek, and light their way to what should be done. Afif Tabara says that morality is the basic pillar that keeps the structure of nations steady. That is why scholars and principals agree on its importance to the welfare of the individual as well as community. Since the individual suffers harm to get hurt from his bad conduct when he follows a course of evil through envy, deceit, and life. So does the society rot when such qualities agree spread among the members? Some of the human values which affect our everyday life, I may mention the following. Forgiveness. Forgiveness is one of the commendable traits which often spring from generous heart and the sensible mind that keeps patience against offense and human forms others. The offense that one receives from others spring mostly from a sick heart and from a mind which has been blinded by evil and as thus deserves one's forgiveness. When someone hurts us deeply, it is not easy to forgive a person. It is common for our minds to be filled with anger and revengeful thoughts. However, such thoughts only harm us further. Forgiveness involves letting go of such thoughts. This may be easier said than done, because depending on one's personality and destiny with the other person, the ability to forgive itself may be compromised. To be free from the trace of an incident, one needs to be able to truly forgive, which includes forgetting the incident itself. And of course, this is not easy to happen. This can only happen if one makes a concentrate efforts on the spiritual practice. So each one of us suffers and faces such a problem, and you say to them, you have to forgive. Okay, but is it an easy job to forgive? Of course, it is not easy. But who can do it? Only the person who has spiritual life, spiritual practice. On a true forgiveness, however, there has been much debate over whatever it also requires positive feeling towards the offender. Most experts, however, agree that it is at least involves letting go of deeply held negative feelings, such as thoughts of indignation, anger, hate, revenge, and resentment. It also includes letting go the expectations that other persons should apologize. So, true forgiveness means that not only forgetting the feeling of anger and revenge, but to forget the incident as well. Of course, this may seem impossible to an average person. From a spiritual perspective, such as level of forgiveness is required in to relinquish all karmic bonds and merge with the divine. Therefore, forgiving and forgetting is what is required from a spiritual perspective to attain God's relation. So, forgiveness sets others free, but mostly it sets us free. When one does spiritual practice, it becomes easier to forgive, and both these aspects help to achieve faster spiritual growth. The duration of intensity of negative thoughts and revenge reduce significantly and one leads to a happier life. Honesty and its fitness and its features. Since nothing can guarantee social stability and confidence among people like honesty, it is considered one of the basic foundation on which societies are built. The moment it disappears, distrust and lack of cooperation immediately take its place in the heart of people. In fact, honesty is a social necessity that deserves enough concern from the family and the school and in contribution to the general welfare. through an honesty, right, is established and people have confidence in one another. Here, when we talk about honesty, we do not specify certain area in the society. It includes all aspects of life, honesty at work, in education, teachers' work, at school, employees in the banks, storekeepers in the shop. Honesty includes everyone in the society. Trust. Trust also is one is a form of honesty. And one of the noblest qualities in individuals and groups. Trust leads to goodness. And because of that, it is considered as a trait to true believer. Without trust, a person lives in a doubt of things around him. Trust is necessary for success in every world. And it is much important in the spiritual life of a person and society. It is an important means to prevent corruption in society because everyone in his place at work or college or takes care of his institution or work because in his inner thinking he is responsible for the work because he trusted in. Also, when we talk about trust, we should talk about trust in God. If we trust in God, God will not leave us. Ask a question, can birds plant or crop the harvest the crops? Can but they leave, birds leave their nest in the morning and went out of their nest to the field, to the nature, hungry. Their abdomens are empty. But when they return back, they return back with full abdomens, full stomachs. Who gave them this food and drink? Who gave them the essence of life to keep living, to give their food? It is their trust of God. So if we trust in God, that He is the one who gives us and who prevents us according to our deeds, He will give us also everything that we need in our life. So trust is important in our life. Now, but I'll give you another example. Solomon the king, God gave him the language to every all creatures. So once he is while he is walking in the road with his soldiers, an ant saw him. So he shouted, that ant shouted to the other ants, go to inside your residences, not to be crushed by Solomon the king and his soldiers without paying attention to you. So they are trusted. So Solomon hears that ant and asks her, why are you so always busy and collecting your food on summer? But in winter, how do you eat? They say that what we collect in summer, we store in our residences for winter. And he said that, now if I give you food for the whole winter, do you come again to gather food to store in your residences? They say yes. The ant says yes. They say, how is that? How I give you, and she said that now someday you may forget us, and how can we get our food? But we trust in God. We trust in God. God will not leave us alone. See. So trust of God can, of course, help us more than anything else. Now, cooperation, another human value. Among the distinguished traits of spiritual life is the practice of cooperation is in virtue to raise the level of social life in contributing to the welfare of the community and the lessening of others' pains. Modern civilization has achieved the principle of cooperation, and thus cooperative associations have spread everywhere, seeking through cooperation to procure more satisfaction to the individual and society. Cooperation is not limited for certain people in the society. It is a feature for all human beings, whatever their religions, languages, races, nationalities. Cooperation should be there. Now, if we cooperate as human beings and have shared the human merits and human values, we share together and we cooperate with each other, what type of society at that time we will live in? Of course, it's a peaceful society. Now, after the cooperation, there's a good relation with others. All things in the market are available on the payment of necessary price. The principle of the market, to be precise, is you receive as much as you give, neither more nor less. This principle is true for entire human life as well. Sometimes has aptly said, give the world the best you have and the best will come back to you. If you are a wisher to others, others will also respond the same way. If you talk to others gently, others will return gentle to you. Return gentle words. If you honor others, others too will honor you. This is a world of give and take. Here man finds only what he has given to others. In short, others will behave with you just as you behave with them. So why don't we select the good things to behave with each other, to have good relations with each other? Okay, this means that in order to lead a life in this world, finding good atmosphere in one's own power, you become friend to others and everyone will become your friend. If you like to live like a flower, you will find your way to a bed of flowers. But if your existence is replete with thorns, you will find a world full of thorns, thorny shrubs. Then there is a blind person who wants to cross. Now, if there is a blind person who wants to cross a street, and there are many people also want to cross the street, do they allow the blind person to cross the street alone, or they take his hand to cross with him? Of course, they do not leave him cross the street alone. What makes them do that? Of course, their pure spirit, their love to have relationship with others. Now, the question is, what makes those people help that blind person to cross the street? Isn't it the human values which we all share with each other? Those people do not do that to the blind person. They do not know his language, his nationality, his religion, his race, his nationality. They are shared. What is the thing that they know about him? That he is a human being and he needs help, even though they help him, because we are all shared in our humanity. Gratitude. Thankfulness is a state of mind which cannot be compartmentalized. It is manifested itself in one place. The chances are that it will do so in other places too. If a man shows gratitude to one person, he will surely show it to others likewise. And of course, here the examples are many, but I will show here I will talk to say that from the gratitude which it must be spread in our society, it should be a relation with a respected relation with all the people in the society, and the teacher and the students is distinguished relation. The relation between the teacher and his students is distinguished. The teacher has an inner feeling with his students are his responsibility, as he has to select the suitable methods for teaching them certain material or certain subject. He has mercy, kindness, and love to his students. On the other hand, the students exchange their teacher the same feeling. So both of them have human values to the other. Do not do good things and forget them. Do not mention the good things to anyone. Let God reward you. Now I give you an example. An old man once visited a doctor in his clinic with his child. He is only a child. So he, after examining, testing the child who was sick, he asked the doctor asked the old man, "Do you have money to buy the medicine?" He said, "No." "Do you have money to buy food for your child? He suffers from anemia, with weakness of blood. Do you have money to purchase food for him?" He said, "No, I do not have." So the doctor, in his drawer, he has samples of medicines. He took one or two medicines from the samples and gave to that man. And he said to him, "I give you this amount of money, just rupees, and said this is for you to ride the bus to go back to your place." So years passed. This example of gratitude passed. One day, the door was knocked, and a policeman entered. They said, "Sir, are you Mr. So-and-so?" He said, "Yes." "Sir, you are needed to the police station." "So what for?" "I am a doctor. I am treating my patients." He said, "No, you are needed and you have to go with us." So he went with them, and the police took him to the police station. There, they said that there is a crime committed in the area where your clinic is, and your name is mentioned there. He said, "This may be mistaken. You are mistaken. I am a doctor in the clinic. I am treating the patients." They say, "No, but these are orders which we receive, and your name is mentioned there." So he requested them that maybe you mistaken the name. They did not interest, took them to the police station, and from there they sent him to jail. In the jail, he found different angry faces, criminals. I said, "What should you do? What should you do?" They say that, "Oh, okay. What is the problem which I fell in?" So that two or three hours after putting them in the jail, a soldier came to him and said, "Sir, we have to shift you from this barracks to a different room." So they put him in a good room, well furnished room, windy. Look over a garden with flowers. There's a TV, newspaper, journals, well-furnished place. "Oh, what is this?" He's surprised. He said, "What's this? Is this a prison? It's a five-star prison. Why do people hate the prison, the jail then?" So he asked that soldier, would you please, who recommended me to be put in this good room? He said the officer of the prison. So may I see him? He said, yes, I will call him. So he went to the officer of the prison, of the chair, and he said that prisoner that want to see you. That the officer came to him and said, yes, sir. Yes, anything. What? How can I help you? He said that, what is this recommendation? Who recommended this room for me? I'm prisoner. You are need me. You are police. He said, that officer said that, sir, you are doctor so-and-so, right? He said, yes. And so remember the old man who came with the child and you treated him in your clinic? He didn't have money at that time. He didn't have to buy medicine, to buy food for his son. He said, yes, many people. I have many people. Well, yeah, one of them is that old man. He said, I am the child. You treated him. And now I become an officer. This is part of my gratitude, to respect you, to put you in the safety place until you will be cleared from here. You see, the gratitude. So do not do good things and ask people for reward me for that. No, leave them and let God in heaven reward you. But you don't know where this reward will come along, will come back to you. Altruism. Another noble quality is altruism, is the good deeds. The motto of noble people who work in the service of humanity. And interpreting the doctrine of Plato, critics once said, self-love is the most serious evil in men, defect and accomplishing and accompanying all of them, all of us from bad. The people seem to find excuses for themselves in having it without sharing the way and for themselves. And of course, with altruism, we have has strong effect on establishing amity and cooperation among people. And here, I mention another example. A mother was walking in the street and she was hungry. She was carrying two daughters in her bosom, carrying in her hands. So one of the people who are passing by, he gave her a date. He gave her three dates. She gave the daughters, each one of the get one date, and she left one for herself. So the daughters, after they finished eating their date, start looking at their mother. So who has the date until now? She didn't eat. So the mother is that, you know, mothers always kind for their children, for all people. All respect to all mothers in the world. So she looked at her daughters looking for that date. She parted it into two halves and gave each one of her daughters a piece of that half. So when she returned back inside herself, she felt that God will remove me, and God rewarded her. God rewarded her with paradise in heaven. So, now I come to some spiritual practices. These are some of the spiritual practices which we may deal with. But according to time, I have to jump to fasting. Food and drink are man's most basic necessities. When we fast, what do we fast from? Stop eating and drinking. Others, other types of fast, stop eating certain types of food. Other types, stop eating or practicing certain activities. So when we fast, we do not only stop drinking and eating only. We do not, because what's the benefit of stop eating and drinking or stop prevent yourself from eating certain type of food, and at the same time you are talking about this, talking about that, doing bad things, rubbing, lying. So is this fasting? This is not the way they say that the person is fasting. Then after that, tolerance. According to Voltaire, tolerance is a law of nature stamped on the heart of all men. So if we are tolerant to each other, but our society, of course, will be a peaceful society. Nothing can be truer than this statement. Tolerance is indeed a prominent law of nature, but it is not something which has to be extremely imposed for the human spirit, for tolerance and is limitless. Just as the truth and honesty are virtues, so is tolerance a virtue. And just as no one ever needs to ask how long one should remain truthful and honest, so does one think that tolerance has having eternal value. The way to tolerance should be, of course, adopted for all of us. Tolerance is an act of compulsion. It is a positive principle in life. So, other human values which we may go through, like honesty, love of others, tolerance, pardon of mistakes, avoiding mistakes, avoiding injustice and hatred, care to spread love among our family, devotion and sincerity in work, perfection, do not harm others, dignity, freedom, security, respond, friendship, trust, commitment, motivation, creativity, continuous learning. All these things are from the human values which we have to keep in our society and to live in. So if we all as human beings, without paying attention to other to our religions, races, languages, just to look at our humanity, spirituality and human values, lead us to have and to lead us to have a beautiful and peaceful life. It has a great effect on our society. By this, where I stop, I end my presentation. Thank you very much for all the organizing committee, for all the listeners, for all the attendants who gave me part of their time to do my presentation. Thank you very much.